Hello, dear learners, dear students. Myself, Mr. Prafulla Tele. I am lecturer in Physics, Science and Humanities Department, Government Polytechnic, Gondia. I am going to teach you a course on basic science. Basic science consists of physics and chemistry, but I will take physics part. Our subject code is 22102. So let us start with unit number 1, units and measurement. Units and measurement. Lecture 1, learning outcomes. Learning outcome means what student learner will able to understand or learn after completion of this lecture. That is the meaning of learning outcome. So our first learning outcome is describe the concept of given physical quantities with relevant unit of measurement. So student will able to understand or able to describe concept of physical quantities, what is meaning of physical quantity, and with some relevant unit of measurement. And second learning outcome is explain various system of units, different system of units, and its need for the measurement of given physical quantities. So they will able to understand and they will able to explain various system of units as well as its need for the measurement of given physical quantity. So these are two our learning outcomes of today's lecture 1. Let us take some daily routine measurement examples. First one example represent measurement of length. In first picture, this one, it shows measurement of shoulder of a given person. It may be in terms of centimeter or inches. Or another example, if I want to give you for the same, I can say distance between Government Polytechnic Gondia and Gondia railway station, the distance is 5 kilometer. Now I have used different unit, kilometer. Similarly, another example, second example, temperature. When you go to the doctor and doctor measures temperature, generally it is in the unit of Fahrenheit. It is represented by F, Fahrenheit. So doctor says it is 101 Fahrenheit. It is not degree Celsius. Kelvin is another unit to measure temperature. There are different units, but these are the examples to understand some example, to understand some temperature things. Units may be different depending on our use. So second example represents it is measurement of temperature when we visit a doctor, or nowadays it is corona, you may visit to any public place or go to any office. First they will measure your temperature with the help of temperature detector, and that temperature, it is in the unit of Fahrenheit, it is not Celsius. Third example of daily routine measurement, either milkman comes to your home or you go to dairy to buy milk, you ask in terms of liter. So it is volume measurement. Third example talks about volume measurement. Either 1 liter, half liter, 2 liter, you don't ask in terms of kg, you ask in terms of liter. Like another example is water bottle of 1 liter, or oil is measured in terms of liter. So volume measurement example. The fourth daily everyday life example is measurement of mass. You go to shop and buy some fruits, or you should ask for sugar. What you ask? It is, you asked in terms of kg. But if you go to buy gold, you ask in terms of grams. So depending on required quantity, you different units are used. So these are some examples of our daily routine. Let me give you introduction. What physics means? Physics is nothing but study of matter and energy and their transformation in the nature. Matter and energy means the entire universe. The entire universe is composed of only two things, matter and energy. मैटर एंड एनर्जी, मैटर मीन्स यू गो टू द स्मॉलेस्ट आइनिक पार्टिकल, यू विल कम अक्रॉस एटम्स, देन फर्दर यू गो यू विल कम अक्रॉस न्यूक्लियर्स, क्वार्क्स, सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स. सो एवरी ऑब्जेक्ट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ एटम्स, मेड अप ऑफ एटम्स दैट वी नो. एंड एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट इट मे बी इन एनी फॉर्म, इट मे बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लाइट और इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव. एंड दिस एंटायर यूनिवर्स इज मेड अप ऑफ मैटर एंड एनर्जी, एंड फिजिक्स इज नथिंग बट स्टडी ऑफ मैटर एंड एनर्जी एंड देयर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इन नेचर. इन दिस वॉट वी स्टडी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लॉज, फिनोमिनाज एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर. इट मे बी डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज, इट मे बी इलेक्ट्रिकल, इट मे बी मैकेनिकल, इट मे बी मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज. सो डिफरेंट सब्सटेंस शोज डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज. सो प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर, देयर फेनोमेना, डिफरेंट फेनोमेनाज, इट मे बी इलेक्ट्रिकल, मैग्नेटिकल और वेरियस फेनोमेनाज, एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लॉज, मे बी गैस लॉज, एनी काइंड ऑफ लॉज विच वी स्टडी इन टर्म्स ऑफ फिजिक्स. सो फिजिक्स इज नथिंग बट स्टडी ऑफ मैटर एंड एनर्जी, एंड ऑल्सो वी स्टडी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लॉज, फेनोमेना एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर. नो वॉट इज द नेसेसिटी ऑफ मेजरमेंट इन इंजीनियरिंग. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज accurate prediction of physical quantity. If you want to measure a length, it should be very accurate. You want to measure a temperature, it should be very accurate. If your measuring instrument temperature is not accurate and it is showing an error of 4 to 5%, if person having temperature 96 and if it detects more than 100, what will happen? The another person will assume the person may have corona. So accurate prediction is very important, and quality assurance of a product. Example, you want to design a display for mobile screen, so it should be very accurate in measurement, precise. So quality is nothing but strength of the object, strength of the material. Quality is talks about precise and accuracy. So these two are very important in measurement, very important aspect of measurement in engineering, because to design any product of required specification, you need to do this too very accurately. So this is nothing but measurement need for engineering point of view. Second, measurement in science point of view. To identify law, what it means. Example is Boyle's law. Let us consider a container which is filled with gas. This is a piston. If P is pressure exerted by gas molecules on wall and V is volume of the container, P is pressure, V is volume of the container, and this we are doing at T equal to constant. Means what? At constant temperature. We are not changing the temperature as well as we are not changing the number of particles inside the container. So P is pressure exerted by gas, V is volume occupied by the gas, and T is temperature which remains constant. Now suppose if you move the piston upward in a given container, it is of the same size, and piston move upward. So what will happen? The gas exert a pressure on wall, that pressure will reduced. Pressure will reduced, and volume of the container occupied by the gas, that volume increases. So what we observe, when pressure decreases, first case pressure is reduced. If you suppress the piston, what will happen? If you come to this point, if you suppress more piston, pressure will reduce, pressure will increase and volume will decrease. And in this way, if you go further more in this direction, what will happen? Pressure will decrease and volume will increase. Volume increases, pressure decreases. So P and V are inversely proportional to each other. What it means? P and V, pressure and V is inversely proportional to volume. So PV equal to constant PV equal to constant, it is called as
Boyle's law.
This law identified by varying various physical parameter. We used four parameter, like example, the number of molecules, second temperature, molecules and temperature we remains fixed, we vary pressure and volume. So we have observed the relation between two physical quantities like pressure and volume. One increases, other decreases. There is inverse proportion. They are inversely proportional to each other. So P into V is constant. So if you want to represent in terms of graph, if it is P and this is volume, then you will get graph of this kind. One increases, other decreases. So pressure increases, volume decreases. Volume increases, pressure decreases. So to identify laws, we need measurement. So with the by measuring pressure and volume, we are able to identify this Boyle's law. So Boyle's discovered in this way, Boyle's law. Second example, to verify some laws. Example, resistances are connected in series. Let us consider an example. This is R1. This is resistance R2. And now they are connected in series. This is battery. Both the resistances are connected in series. This is the battery and I is current flowing through the circuit. Now if these are two resistance R1 and R2 and they are connected in series, so theoretically we can derive their equivalent resistance R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 when they are connected in series. Their equivalent resistance is given by R1 plus R2. This is R1, this is R2. Example, if this is 5 ohm and this is also 5 ohm, then R equivalent is 10 ohm. 5 plus 5, 10 ohm. So this is theoretical equation of equivalent resistance. Now in laboratory, what we do? We connect both the resistances in series. Then we measure resistance across this resistance, we measure resistance across this resistance, and also we measure the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. How it is? If total I is the current flowing through circuit, V is the applied voltage, then by Ohm's law, R is equal to, V is equal to IR, so R is equal to V by I. I is current flowing through the circuit, V is applied potential difference, so you will get R equivalent by using this circuit and by measuring equivalent resistance with the help of experiment in the laboratory, and we verify the laws. So there are many examples that we do measurement in physics laboratory similar to this one, like resistance you connect in parallel, we measure both the, or we verify Ohm's law also, V equal to IR in the laboratory. So to verify laws, we use measurement. Now let us understand the unit of a physical quantity. What is mean by unit? The definition is standard used for measurement of a physical quantity. Standard used for measurement of physical quantity. Let me give you one example. You go to the market and ask for fruits. Give me 1 kg fruit or 1 kg apple. 1 kg apple. Or you may ask 4 kg rice. If 4 kg rice you are asking to the shopkeeper, this 4 number, it is a number. This 4 indicates it is the quantity. And this kg indicates standard to use for measurement. So the standard used for measurement of a physical quantity is called unit. In upcoming slides, we'll see what is mean of physical quantity. Physical quantity's meaning. We'll understand what is mean by physical quantity. And to measure any physical quantity, that quantity must be represented in terms of some standard. Another example I will give you, 5 centimeter length, where 5 is a number, it is some quantity, and centimeter is unit of measurement. It may be kilometer, centimeter, degree, Celsius, for or various parameter, various, like you can go for various physical quantities one by one. Example, volume, liter. Then mass, kg, gram. If you buy, go to gold shop, you ask in terms of gram, gold. Give me 4 gram, 5 gram, 10 gram. But don't, we need not ask in terms of kgs in gold shop. So that is the standard used for measurement of a physical quantity. So unit is nothing but a standard that is used to represent a particular physical quantity. Now there are some requirements of standard. What are these requirements? This unit should be universally accepted. That means wherever you go, either you go to the Gondia, Nagpur, Mumbai or USA or any country in the world, it should be understandable, it should be acceptable. So universally accepted. You ask 1 kg apple in India or you ask for 1 kg apple in America, Canada, Europe, you will get same amount of quantity, that is standard unit. So it should be universally accepted. Second, definite and well defined. Unless and until it is definite, fixed and well defined, you will not understand what it means. What is the meaning of kg? It should not invariable with time and place. That means 1 kg is different at a daytime and at night 1 kg is something else. It does not. So invariable, not changing with respect to time as well as place. So it is not changing with respect to time and place. 1 kg means 1 kg. Either you buy daytime or nighttime or any time or at any place. That is 1 kg means 1 kg. That is the invariable with respect to. Easily reproducible. Easily available, reproducible, non-perishable. Perishable means destroyable. So it should not be easily reproducible. It should be easily reproducible and non-perishable. Easily comparable with other unit. That means one unit of measurement of mass is gram and another one is kg, so we should be comparable. That means 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg, so they are easily comparable with other units of measurement and easily available. If they are not available easily, you will not able to use it and you will not able to understand. In daily life we require so many different standard units, and these are the requirements of standard unit. If they are followed, then you will get a unit. So unit, again, unit is nothing but standard that we used for measurement of physical quantities, and these are the requirement that we have seen related to unit of physical quantity. Now let us understand physical quantity. What is mean by physical quantity? Definition of physical quantity. A physical property which can be measured and described by a number is called physical quantity. A physical property which can be measured, that means you will able to measure and describe by a number, is called physical quantity. There are some examples which I have given on the screen. First example, mass of a person is 65 kg. 65 kg is, 65 is number and kg is unit, and mass is the physical quantity. Physical quantity is mass. You are measuring mass of a person. 65 is quantity and kg is unit. So any physical property, here physical property is nothing but mass of person, that is physical property. It is measurable. Yes, it is measurable. It is 65 kg and it is described by number. 65 is a number, so that is a physical quantity. Another example, length of table is 3 meter. Length is a physical quantity. It is table physical quantity is measurement of length, and it is measurable and it is 3 meter. 3 is quantity, how much, and m is meter, which is the unit. Another, area of this given hall is 100 meter square. 100 meter square area, another physical quantity. Length into breadth, area is nothing but length into breadth of a hall, and that is equal to 100 meter square. Temperature of a room is 300 Kelvin. Kelvin is another unit. of measurement of temperature like degree Celsius. So physical quantity that is measurable and described by some number, that is called as physical quantity. These are some examples to understand physical quantity. Let me give you another example of quantity which is not a physical quantity. If I ask a question, how much Katrina Kaif is beautiful? You may answer, she is very beautiful. But can you describe in terms of numbers? No. So that beauty is not a physical quantity. You cannot measure beauty in terms of numbers. You cannot represent it. So that beauty of Katrina Kaif or any actress you take, that is not a physical quantity. Contrary example we have taken to understand the physical quantity. Let us go to the next slide. There are some quantities which are fundamental quantities. Now what is mean by fundamental quantities? Now we have understood physical quantities, in which it is divided into two types, fundamental and derived. So let us understand fundamental quantities. Fundamental quantities are physical quantities which does not depend on any other physical quantities for their measurement, are known as fundamental. So physical quantities which does not depend on other physical quantities for their measurement are known as fundamental physical quantities. Example, length. If you want to measure a length of a table which is 3 meter, do you require another quantity? Do you need any mass or do you need any more length? No, only once you are measuring a length. So you don't require any other physical quantity for measurement of length. You don't need anything, only once, one quantity which is length you required. You don't require any other quantity like mass, so, or temperature. To understand length, you don't require temperature. That means length only you are using once. So measurement of length of a table is a fundamental quantity. Second example, mass. You are measuring a mass. Do you require another physical quantity to measure mass? To measure mass, you need to understand temperature, or you need to understand length, or you need to understand size. Doesn't matter. You want to buy 1 kg, substance may be different, but 1 kg means 1 kg, and it does not depend on other physical quantity, that is fundamental quantity. Third example is temperature. So temperature also does not depend on any other parameter. You measure temperature in terms of Kelvin, maybe in terms of degree Celsius, or maybe in terms of Fahrenheit. These are different units to measure temperature. Length you can measure in terms of centimeter, in terms of meter, or in terms of kilometer. Various units you can use for measurement. Similarly for mass, you can have gram, you can have kilogram. Time measurement, we measure in terms of second, minute, and hours. So time is another physical quantity, fundamental physical quantity, which does not require any other quantity for their measurement. To measurement time, do you want any quantity? Length? No. To measurement time, you require to measure only time. So that is very simple definition. Physical quantity which does not depend on any other physical quantities for their measurement are known as fundamental quantity. Good. Now I think you understand fundamental quantities. Let us move to another type of quantities. Derived quantities. The physical quantities which depends on one or more fundamental quantities. They depends on more fundamental quantities. It may be one or it may be more fundamental quantities for their measurements are known as derived quantities. Now you take first example, area. To measure area of a hall, what you need to measure? You need to measure length and breadth. They both are nothing but length, but you are measuring length twice, not single, not once. So you are measuring length and breadth, which is nothing but measurement of length two times. That means it depends on सेम क्वांटिटी मोर देन वंस, इवन इट डिपेंड्स ऑन सेम क्वांटिटी मोर देन वंस, इट इज अ डिराइव्ड वन, इट इज नॉट फिजिकल. द क्वांटिटी मे बी डिफरेंट और मे बी सेम. सो एरिया इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ लेंथ, इट इज नथिंग बट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ, इट इज नथिंग बट टू टाइम्स लेंथ. सो एरिया इज अ डिराइव्ड क्वांटिटी, यू आर मेजरिंग लेंथ टू टाइम्स. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल डेंसिटी, मास अपॉन वॉल्यूम. टू मेजर डेंसिटी, डेंसिटी इज डिफाइंड एज इट इज नथिंग बट रेशियो ऑफ मास टू द वॉल्यूम. सो टू नो डेंसिटी यू शुड नो मास एज वेल एज यू शुड नो वॉल्यूम. सो देर आर टू डिफरेंट क्वांटिटीज, मास अनदर क्वांटिटी, वॉल्यूम अनदर. वॉल्यूम इट सेल्फ इज अ डिराइव्ड, बिकॉज वॉट इज वॉल्यूम, लेंथ इंटू ब्रेड्थ इंटू हाइट. Length into breadth into height is nothing but volume. Volume itself is a derived quantity. So mass upon volume is a derived quantity. Third quantity, force. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Mass is another quantity, physical quantity. Acceleration is derived quantity. So depends, force depends on two parameters, mass and acceleration. So it is a derived quantity. Another example, pressure. Force upon area. Force is derived quantity itself, area is also derived quantity, but there are already two derived quantities, so pressure is a derived quantity. So derived quantity means very simple to understand. For its measurement, if required, same physical quantity may be more than once, or different physical quantities, or two, one, more than one physical quantity is required, then it is nothing but derived quantities. I think this is these examples are very good enough to understand the derived and physical. So fundamental means does not depend, and derived means depend on another fundamental, another quantities. Now our second learning outcome was system of units. There are different types of systems. Here I have given in terms of table. First system is CGS system, where length is measured in terms of centimeter, mass is measured in terms of gram, and time is measured in terms of second. That is called as CGS system, centimeter gram system, second. So CGS system, length is measured in centimeter, mass is in gram, and time is in seconds. Second system is MKS, length is measured in terms of meter, mass is measured in terms of kilogram, and time is measured in terms of second. Third one is foot pound system, second. FPS system, length is measured in terms of foot, mass is in terms of pound, and time is in terms of second. So these are different system of units which generally used, but we all refer to this standard used by everyone, SI system. These are different system, but generally we used most of the time the standard fourth one, SI system. CGS means centimeter gram second, MKS means meter kg kilogram second, FPS means foot pound second. The fourth one is, and these are interrelated to with each other, that means you can convert one to another, you can convert one to another. Example, if you want to convert meter to centimeter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Kilogram to gram, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Second is the same one. So you can interlink, you can convert one system to another system. The fourth thing is very important, SI system. Now SI system, in SI units or in SI system, there are 7 fundamental units and 2 supplementary units. Let us understand it with the help of this simple table. These are 7 fundamental quantities and its unit and symbol, and they are measured in terms of these SI units. These units are nothing but SI, standard international. So fundamental quantity is, first one is length. Length is measured in SI meter and its symbol is small m. We know about length. Second, mass, it is measured with kilogram in SI system, its symbol is kg. थर्ड इज टाइम, एसआई यूनिट इज सेकेंड, सिंबल इज एस. फोर्थ टेम्परेचर, टेम्परेचर एसआई यूनिट इज केल्विन एंड इट इज मेजर्ड बाय के. नॉर्मली वी नो द डिग्री सेल्सियस एट 100 डिग्री वाटर बॉइल्स एंड वी नो फारेनहाइट आल्सो बिकॉज व्हेन वी विजिट टू डॉक्टर फारेनहाइट. सो यू स्टार्ट रिड्यूसिंग टेम्परेचर. लेट अस कंसिडर वाटर एट 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड नाउ वॉट यू डू, यू स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर by 1 degree Celsius below. So we can reach up to minus 273 degree Celsius. The smallest one up to which we can reach is minus 273 degree Celsius. That means minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. You can go on reducing the temperature, you can reach up to minus 273 degree. That temperature is called as absolute zero. Absolute zero. And that absolute zero is called as Kelvin. Where Kelvin start. So that absolute zero is Kelvin. So this 273, if water is at 0 Celsius, it means it is at 273 Kelvin. If our room temperature is 27 degree Celsius, then you have to add it 273 and it is nothing but 300. Addition of these two is 300 Kelvin. So room temperature is 300 Kelvin. So Kelvin is nothing but another unit, fundamental quantity is temperature and its SI unit is Kelvin. It is represented by K. Another unit is electric current. Everyone knows this electric current measured in terms of ampere. Let me give you one example. If you switch on the fan, the current which is flowing through a wire is electric current, and that current is 5 ampere to switch on the fan. But if you want to switch on the AC, how much you require? That current you may require a switch of the order of 25 ampere or 15 to 25 ampere. So electric current is another physical quantity which you can measure. Its unit of measure, SI unit, is ampere, and it is denoted by symbol A. Another physical quantity is, sixth one is luminous intensity. Luminous represent light, and intensity means, intensity is nothing but, what is mean by intensity? Intensity is nothing but number, suppose this is the torch, battery or torch, and light is coming from it, from a light source, maybe any source of light. Light is coming from the source and you are receiving this light on this particular area. This A is area. So amount of light received per unit area, per unit time, the amount of light, or you may call it in terms of photons. Suppose light is made up of photon, so number of photons received per unit area, per unit time, is nothing but intensity. So luminous intensity talks about light intensity, where number of photons, they are nh nu, number of photons, light photons, particle incident on area A per unit time, that we called intensity, and it is measured with the help of unit candela, represented by CD. Symbol is CD. So candela is unit of intensity. So intensity is nothing but energy received per unit area, per unit time. And luminous means it is related to light, luminous intensity. Next, last example of fundamental unit is amount of substance, mole. Its unit is mole. Its unit symbol is mol. Generally, normal layman, you can say, common man, do not know this symbol, amount of substance in terms of mole. Have you go to the market and ask any substance in terms of mole? No, never. But generally, science background or pharmacist or chemistry people, they talk in terms of moles. What is mean by mole? Let me give you one example to understand mole. Consider H2O water. H2O, it has two hydrogen, one oxygen. The atomic number of hydrogen is 1 and atomic number of oxygen is 16. So there are two hydrogens. So hydrogen H2 means its atomic number is 2 and this is O is 16, so it is 18. So when you take 18 gram of water, 18 gram of water, that is nothing but one mole substance, and it may be different one for different substance. The weight need not to be same. If you go for another substance, it may come out some another number, need not to be 18. But what is another way to define this mole? It contains, that amount of substance contains Avogadro's number of molecule. Avogadro's number of molecules. Avogadro's number is 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules in this much amount. So Avogadro number, what says, this 18 gram of water contains 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 H2O molecules. That is, that much amount is mole. Now let us, so we have understood this 7 fundamental units. These are 7 fundamental units. Now we will go to understand there are 2 more units which are supplementary unit. Let us understand these 2 also. In next slide we will see this 2 supplementary unit. The first one is radian. It is used to measure a plane angle. Consider an example, this OA is radius, OB is also radius, theta is angle between AOB and AB is nothing but arc. So theta is defined as arc upon radius. This we have learned in school. Theta is equal to arc upon radius. This equation we know from school level. So theta is equal to arc upon radius. If your arc is same as arc length is same as r, what will happen? R by r, 1. And what we are measuring? We are measuring this theta is nothing but plane angle. It is two dimensional object. Circle is a two dimensional object, and we are measuring plane angle of that circle, and it is theta is equal to arc upon radius. If you take arc equal to radius of a circle, then r by r, it is equal to 1. So this theta is nothing but 1 radian. What I have shown in the diagram is 1 radian, measurement of 1 radian. How much you can measure maximum? The entire circle, if you go, the circumference of a circle. So circumference of a circle is 2 pi r divided by, so to theta, for entire circle, it is 2 pi r is circumference divided by r. R will get cancelled. So this entire 360 degree is nothing but 2 pi radian. This 360 degree is nothing but 2 pi radian. So it is another supplementary unit, radian, to measure plane angle. Next one is steradian. Steradian is used to measure solid angle. The example to understand this is very simple. You take ice cream cone. Now in ice cream cone, if you look at the ice cream cone, can you measure plane angle? No. The angle seen by you from outside, the cone angle, angle made by cone, the entire angle made by cone, this omega shown in diagram, is nothing but a solid angle. and it is measured in steradian. So what is mean by one steradian? One steradian means this area of this particular area divided by r square. Steradian definition is area divided by r square. Area upon r square. Now you look at the given diagram. What area I have chosen? The area represented on this cone, this is nothing but circle, and area of that circle is given by r square. So r square by r square, it is equal to 1. What it means, this diagram represent one steradian. What this diagram represent? It is one steradian. So angle one steradians means when area is equal to r square, then you will get this angle subtended by this area at the center is nothing but solid angle, and that angle is equal to one steradian when that area is equal to r square. Now I will give you another example to understand this very clearly. Consider a sphere. What is area of a sphere? For entire sphere, if you take a cone and you go around all the direction, what you will obtain? You will obtain a sphere, three dimensional object, sphere. The area of sphere is nothing but 4 pi r square upon r square. So this r square will get cancelled, and what we will get? 4 pi. So if I ask solid angle for the entire sphere is nothing but 4 pi. The angle subtended by entire sphere, spherical object at its center is 4 pi. That is the maximum one. And 1 means when the area subtended angle at its center of a spherical object, and if that area equal to r square, then it is one steradian. So you have understood steradian is solid angle. So these two are supplementary unit, plane angle and solid angle. Now let us solve some example related to